If you have been following the vlogs, then you recognize the setup right here. We are back in Jacksonville. And I was just thinking to myself, like, this setup, this room, reminds me of so many days of prep. I think I spent like a month here during like my last 3 months of prep or something like that. So even like this bathroom, I remember weighing in on that every single morning, doing physique updates for Patrick right in front of this mirror. I miss looking good, being in like a different conditioning, but I do not miss the lifestyle of meticulously tracking macros, tracking everything, weighing in every morning. It's a whole new level of discipline. I like being here where the vibes are. I can eat whatever I want, do whatever I want. It's a little more chill in Jacksonville now. Back here for a couple days with Jeff and Steph. We're filming some content for like the month of November and then like the month of December. There was supposed to be a vlog that was going up when I was leaving Kelowna. So just ignore this skip timeline because I didn't make that vlog. I had a lot going on that week when I was leaving Kelowna. So during that vlog, I was going to update you guys. I finally got all the samples in that I was trying to get for the next launch that I'm trying to put together. But you guys saw like the mock-ups for these samples. The black one I'm actually wearing right now, collection 3 with Kosher Apparel right under there. Nice, dope black hoodie. Like I said, you guys already saw the mock-ups of these, so you kind of already know what they're looking like. And then we got this sport gray, which actually has the same thing, but this one is actually a screen print of collection 3, and the one that I'm wearing is actually like an embroidery. So we're really in love with this like color combination of white and gray. I also marked up a new design for the hats. So we got collection 3 here. Excuse this dirt. I've actually been wearing this hat like a lot, but on the side we got K plus APL. I will say there's like a lot of things wrong with these samples. I'm in the process of like redesigning how I'm doing stuff in the back end, getting new suppliers, how I design my tech packs to go out to suppliers. So it's going to be like a lot of trial and error over these next few weeks before we like perfect this launch, because I just can't send out anything. There's a couple things wrong with this hoodie. So I already put those changes in to get some new samples coming in over like the next couple weeks. Everything goes well and we are on our way to like a early January launch. It's a long process. Personally, I'm just going to be more proud if I take my time and make sure everything is perfect with them. You only want to spend my money, but you don't get a dollar from me. Dollar bills. I should probably mention what happened to my eye. I realized when I was shooting those clips earlier that I didn't really give any background on that. It looks pretty bad too.
Let me see. Is it here on the inside?
Yeah.
I see that.
I looked like Mufasa. Nothing really. I was playing basketball over at LA Fitness and like the games were like, they were good games, super intense, and people are just hacking, fouling. I'm down in the paint getting physical. This wasn't even a foul, by the way. Like, they didn't even call that foul.
What?
Nope.
Welcome to Florida.
I didn't even get that foul, so ready.
They spoiled us, bro.
Not even close to being to the drive-thru.
I know.
My man's already out here taking orders, man. Welcome to Chick-fil-A. Bro, the difference is just crazy.
It's like, not even the same planet.
We're like driving along the sidewalk, and she's walking with the car, with the machine.
I know.
Taking the order. She takes the money, the order. We just drive up to the drive-thru, take our food, and leave. Like, everything is so fluent at Chick-fil-A. And I forgot to tell you guys, but if you saw my story then, the experience that we had at Popeyes was like polar opposite. You know what I mean? Like, 20 minutes to get to the drive-thru thing. We get there, and then she makes us wait another 5 minutes, no exaggeration, 5 minutes, mm-hmm. putting us on hold at the menu thing. And then we go through the drive-thru, and there's potholes. We almost broke down in the middle of the drive-thru. And then the food was like lukewarm. It was overhyped. Man, we're back at Chick-fil-A to repent our sins. You can't replace it. You can't beat it.
We got a Trump supporter and we got us. You know, it's the only place we can all get along.
It's, not really.
It's Chick-fil-A. We all get along, man.
We're kind of reminiscing on the experience we had at Popeyes. Like I said, it was terrible. Absolutely ridiculous and terrible. I actually did on my story give it an 8 out of 10 for the sandwich. Pretty good. When we start factoring in the overall experience from the actual Popeyes, it was exactly what you see on Instagram. Like, those memes are real. Like, the workers don't care. Popeyes, the franchise, don't care. And the food, you can see there's no care in it either. Like, things just thrown in the bag. It was terrible. It was just bad. But
you want to update that rating
yet? I mean, I'm going to update my rating. Like, if we're factoring all that in, I'm going to update my rating. And it's definitely 5 out of 10.
Yeah.
5 out of 10, man. That's just off the sandwich alone, because experience was zero.
Yeah. I can't really get much worse.
You can't get much worse than
honking
what it was.
At me from behind. Yeah. Like,
and we got honked at because we didn't move up in the drive-thru, and it was literally like split second. Like, he saw Buddy move up, split second, start honking. He's like, bro, like, you're going to get your chicken sandwich. Like, it's not going to sell out today. Relax.
So when I'm traveling, I have to admit, I am super inconsistent with my training, especially if I'm somewhere for like a week or two. I find like I just get like so into work and I'm like, oh, I'll just get back to training when I'm home. That's kind of been the mindset right now. We got a couple more days down south. I think 5 more days total before we head back to Canada. And as soon as I get back in Canada, I'm getting right back on my split. I'm getting right back on my training because I miss training every day at my home gym. It's just a different vibe. If you have a gym that you go to every day, you already know when you're traveling, it just, the workouts are just not the same working out in other gyms. So I'm hyped to get back home, get back to like those gritty workouts at my home gym. One thing I will say before I end this video is I had a couple of people asking about the 10K challenge that I'm gonna do with Selma. She's in Guatemala right now. I'm in Florida right now. So haven't got the chance to film that video, but her and I are finally back together. We'll get that video going and I'll get that out for you guys. But I'm gonna end the video right here. If you're new, join the crew, subscribe to the channel, leave this video a like before you leave, and I'm gonna catch you guys in the next video. Damn, whoa, you need the red carpet. You look like a movie, you need the red carpet.